So first of all, thank you very much for subscribing to this channel and thank you very much for watching my videos. So today we are going to study topic volume type 1 questions. When I talk about type 1 questions are mainly questions based on cube. Okay, then we have type 2 questions, type 3 questions, type 4 questions of volume. Like we will be solving questions based on cylinder, we will be solving questions based on cone, then hemisphere, sphere, like that. Okay, cylinders like that. So today type 1 we are solving questions based on cube. Okay, so let us see some of the important questions from type 1. So here is your first question. So the first question is, the volume of a wall 5 times as high as is broad and 8 times as long as is high is 18,225 cubic meters. Find the breadth of the wall. It is given the volume of the wall 5 times as high as is broad and 8 times as long as is high is 18,225. So you need to find the breadth of the wall. So from this question, students, what is given and what we need to find out? It's very clear. If the total volume is given 18,850, let us write that. So the total volume given is, volume V is equal to 18,225. The total volume given is 18,225 and the conditions are given. We have length, breadth and height. Breadth is we need to find out. So let us take breadth is equal to x. So according to the given question, height is equal to 5 times of breadth. So here I can take it as 5x and length is 8 times of height. That is equal to 8 times of height, 8 into 5x. So this will become 40x. I hope you understood. From the given question, breadth is x, height is 5 times of breadth, so 5x, and length is 8 times of height. So we get 8 into 5x equal to 40x. But we know the volume. Volume is equal to what? Volume is equal to length into breadth into height. That means 40x into x into 5x will be equal to 18,225, because 18,225 is the volume that is already given. So now 40 into 5, 200, 200x into x into x, x cube is equal to 18,225. So now 2x cube is what then? So x cube is equal to 18,225 divided by 200. So I can cut it with 5, 5 here 40 times, 5 here 3 times, 32, 6 times, 22, 4 times, 25, 5 times. Again I can cut it with 5, here it is 8 times, here 5, 7 times, 14, 2 times, then 45, 9 times. So I got what? I got x cube is equal to 729 by 8. So x cube is equal to 729. 729 can be written as what? 729 is equal to 9 into 9 into 9. 8 can be written as what? 2 into 2 into 2. So x cube is equal to this. So what will be x? X is equal to, out of this 3, 1 you have to take. So 9 by 2. 9 by 2 is equal to what actually? 4.5. So x is equal to 4.5 meter. So we got breadth. X is equal to 4.5 meter. That is the correct answer. Isn't it? So this is the way you have to approach these type of questions. What is given? The length, breadth and height. If you know the length, breadth and height, then it is easy to find out the volume of a cube or a cuboid. So type 1 questions, we are talking about cube and cuboid. Volume of a cube, is equal to a cube. Volume of a cuboid, length into breadth into height. So they have given us a condition, the relationship between length, breadth and height. Breadth we have taken x. If breadth is x, height is given as 5 times of breadth. So we have taken as 5x and height is 8 times of the height. So 8 into 5x, 40x. When you multiply these three, we get the volume. Volume is already given in the question, 18 225. So on simplification, we got x is equal to 9 by 2. 9 by 2 is equal to what actually? 4.5 meter. So accordingly, we have taken breadth is equal to 4.5 meter. Kindly note it. So let us go to the next question. So the next question is here on your board. What's the question? The question is, the length, breadth and thickness of a rectangular coil are as 7 is to 4 is to 3 and its whole surface area is 1098 square centimeter. Find the length, breadth and thickness. So a ratio is given here, 7 is to 4 is to 3. So let us write the ratio first. The given ratio is what? 7 is to 4 is to 3. So let us take 7 is the length, 4 is the breadth and 3 is the height or thickness. Height and thickness are the same. Okay. So now let us take a length is equal to 7, 4, 3 ratio. So first ratio we will take it as 7x and breadth we will take as 4x and height or thickness. Height we will take it as 3x. Height and thickness all same only. So length, breadth, height, or you can say length, breadth and thickness. So 7x, 4x and 3x. Now if you find out x, put x the value here, then you can find out what is the total length, what is the total breadth and what is the total height. For this, one more ratio, one more information is given in the question. The surface area, total surface area is given to you 1098 square meter square. So this is the area is also given to you. So these all are the informations given in the question, what we have written first. Now what is given? Total surface area is equal to, total surface area of a rectangular coil is equal to 2 into LB, length into breadth, plus LB into BH into LH. LB plus BH plus LH. 2 into LB, length into breadth, plus breadth into height, plus length into height. This is the formula for the total surface area of a cuboid, or you can say a cubical thing, or you can say a cuboid or a rectangular coil or whatever it is. Okay. So now, TSA is given to you. How much? 1098. So 1098 is equal to 2 into L into B. L into B, that is length into breadth. 7 into 4, 28x square, plus B into H. Breadth into height, 4 into 3, 12x square, plus L into H, length into height, 7 into 3, 21x square. So you got 1098 is equal to 2 into 28 plus 12, 40, 40 plus 21, 61, 61x square. So 2 into 61 is equal to 122x square. So now we can say 122x square is equal to 1098. So I will take 122x square is equal to 1098. So I can write x square is equal to 1098 by 122. When I cut 1098 by 122, you can simplify it. Then you can simplify it, which is equal to 9. So x square is equal to 9. If x square is equal to 9, x square is equal to 9, therefore x will be equal to 3. You got the value of x only here. Okay, we got the value of x only, but we need to find out the length, breadth and height. So now put the value of x here, 7 into x. X is equal to 3. So 7 into 3, 21. So length we got, length is equal to 21 meter. And breadth, 4 into 3, 4x, 4 into 3, 12. So breadth is equal to 12 meter and height, 3 into x, 3x, 3 into 3 is equal to, that is height or thickness, h is equal to 3 into 3, 9 meter. So this is our final answer. This is what you need to find out in the options. Okay. So these type of questions are called type 1 questions, friends. Type 1 questions, we have questions based on cube and cuboid. Okay. So kindly note it. So let us go to the next question. So the next question is here on your board, friends. What is the question? The edge of a cube is 20 centimeter. How many small cubes of 5 centimeter edge can be formed from this cube? Edge of a cube is 20 centimeter. How many small cubes you can make each of edge 5 centimeter? Okay, so you have a big cube. Edge of the cube is 20 centimeter, and you want to make small cubes of 5 centimeter edge. So it is, you can say it is like this. You have a big cube. So this cube, one edge is equal to 20. So all sides are 20. So such a big cube you have, 20 each. From here, you want to make small cubes. Like this, small cubes you want to make. Each 5 centimeter. So the question is, how many such cubes you can make out of this? So this is a question. So now the answer is also very simple. You need to find out the total volume of this cube. So you need to find out the volume of one small cube and divide it. So you'll get a number, that many small cubes we can find out. So now, what is the volume of this cube? Volume of a cube is a cube. So a cube means side cube, that is 20 cube. So what is 20 cube? 20 into 20. 2 into 2, 4. 4 into 2, 8. 8,000. 8,000 centimeter cube. That is the volume of the bigger cube. Isn't it? So we need to find out the volume of small cube now. So what is the volume of small cube? That is a cube is equal to 5 cube. That is 5 into 5, which is equal to 5 are 25. 25 into 5, 125 centimeter cube. So the question is, how many cubes you can make? So how many cube you can make? Bigger volume divided by smaller volume. So what is bigger volume? Number of cube is equal to, bigger volume is 8,000 divided by smaller one, 125. So 8,000 divided by 125, how many times? You can cut it with 5, 25 times. You can cut it with 5, 1,600. Again, you can cut it with 25, 6,4. So you can say 64 cubes you can make. Number of cubes you can make is 64. Okay, so from the bigger cube we can make 64 small cube of each side 5 centimeter. So what actually we have to do is the volume, total volume of the bigger one divided by the total volume of the smaller one, you will get the total number of cubes we can find out. These type of questions are very, very common in almost every competitive exams. So these all are, again I am repeating, it is type 1 questions of volume. When we talk about type 1 question of volume, the questions are based on cube and cuboid. Okay, then we will go to, in the upcoming videos, we will be going with the type 2, type 3, where we will discuss about cylinder, cone, hemisphere, sphere, etc. Okay, so this type of questions are very important for your examination. Please note it. Let's go to our next question, friends. So the next question is here on your board. What's the question? From a cube of 8 meter side, a square hole of side 2 meter is punched right through between a pair of opposite faces. Find the volume of the remaining solid. So you have a cube. So the cube, let it be like this. This is a bigger cube. So this cube, each side is 8 centimeter. So here is also 8, here also is 8, 8, all 8. From here, we are punching a hole with a square hole with a 2 centimeter dimension. So I am punching it here. This is 2 centimeter, this is also 2 centimeter. And I want this hole to be punched from this side to the back side, from face to face, that is pair of opposite faces. Means if I do it from here, it should go to the back side. When it go to the back side, it will go up to here. when it goes up to here and it will come in this back side, so this length will be 8, because the bigger cube, the total length, the total side is 8 centimeter. So here only it is 2, it is 2 here, 2 here, and this will be 8. So the square hole will be like this. This is 2, this is 2, and this side will be 8. Isn't it? Yes. So this many portion you are removing from the bigger cube. This portion you are removing from the bigger cube, and then we have been asked to find out the volume of the remaining part. So what is the answer? Total volume minus this volume. So what is the total volume? Total volume is equal to 8 cube. That is 8 into 8 into 8. So 8 8s are 64. 64 into 8 512 centimeter cube. So that is the total volume of this cube. Out of this total volume, what we have done? We have removed this part. So what is the volume of the part we removed? 2 into 2 into 8. So volume of square, this volume will be, volume removed will be equal to 2 into 2 into 8. 2 2s are 4, 4 into 8, 32 centimeter square. So from 512, 32 centimeter square we are removing. So what is left out? So the remaining volume, will be 512 minus 32. When you do this simplification, you get the answer 480. So 480 centimeter cube will be the remaining volume. When you punch this hole and take it out, the remaining volume will be 480 centimeter cube. Okay, what we have done, from the big cube we have punched a hole, a square hole, and removed that much area, that much volume. So what will be the remaining volume? That is the question. Okay, kindly note it.